chill in my bones that won't come out. Too many nights out sleeping in the fog. Doing them any good. eyes open. Something's stalking us. Someone or something else here. Always sell what we can't use ourselves.
Rustle up some grub. Our corral is more than just okay. You're listening to the Eden Meadows Drive-In Cinema's radio broadcast. The night at the movies beats boring conversation and family board game night every time. Here's what's playing now. It's Night of the Fishman's Revenge, starring Carl Dixon, Cynthia Marsh. You'll be frozen to your seat with fear. Just listen.
will be Sven's life.
If you thought that sounded great, wait until you get a load of what's coming soon. At Eden Meadow Cinema. It's Murder Most Foul on the Steam Train and Bernard Switchback's latest thriller, The Murder Express. You'll be surprised at the killers and their low motive. Boy, that sounded exciting. Not as exciting as what's playing this weekend at Eden Meadows Drive-In Cinemas. Grab your pistols. Get ready for an old-fashioned standoff as the Fight and Furies return. And last stand at Fort McGee.
The Fight and Furies return.
Hungry? Partner? Why not mosey up to the concession stand and rustle up some grub? Our corral is more than just okay. You're listening to the Eden Meadows Drive-In Cinemas radio broadcast. A night at the movies beats boring conversation and family board game night every time. Here's what's playing now. Leave the kiddos at home for this next one. Night of the Fishman's Revenge will have them shaking in their socks. Space Rogue Blast Hannigan saved the day. Raiders from beyond our galaxy.
This place is a nest of shamblers. Seem to like that big screen. God knows why.
Got it.
Looks exciting. Wish I could have seen it. Best to grab it now while you can.
That's it.
Let's get this over with. First rule of surviving is to put everything to use.
Now you're realizing what a mistake you made.
Your own blood, you bastard.
What the hell happened?
I'll be straight with you. It's never easy to ask anyone on this island for help, much less a stranger. But I've got a responsibility to these people, and I have a job for you if you're up for it. Besides, I know you're tougher than you look.
What exactly do you need help with?
We get our drinking water from a purifier not far outside of town. We had a bad storm not long before you got here, and it must have damaged the fog condensers that protect the road to the purifier. I sent Howard Dunbar out to fix them. He was out there when the Mirelurks hit us, and I'm afraid they might have got him, too. I was hoping you might go have a look. If the worst happened, maybe you could get those fog condensers back online. If you're up to it, just head south out of town. It's paying work, of course. I wouldn't ask a stranger to stick their neck out on our behalf, unless I was willing to pay a fair share for it.
Am I gonna need any tools or parts if I have to make these repairs on my own?
The fog condensers need their power modules replaced, but Howard took the only spares we had. Either way, you're gonna have to find him first.
All right, I'll head out there now.
Good. Our water supply won't last much longer.
I lost my home when the fog rolled in.
You need it? The bait shop's got it.
Guns, ammo, and souvenirs. Got them all there in stock.
You been to the tannery? You find my tools yet?
Can you tell me about the tannery?
A man named Pauly used to camp there. Very handy fellow. Fog rolled in a year back. and he had to pull up his stake. He left the harbor recently, so everything that's there is fair salvage.
Here are your tools.
A fair bit of luck running into you. Here's your reward. Well earned. And now to work on the hull.
Fresh shipping. All your
medical manner of good I can do with those tools.
If you ain't armed, you ain't long for this world. Buy my guns now.
I'm scraping by.
Food in front, dock in back.
The children of Adam are dangerous. Don't trust them. Poor old Grandpa George. Torn apart by a fog crawler. The island hasn't got a shred of decency.
Grandpa George can rest in peace. Fog crawler is dead.
Wonderful. That's another chapter successfully concluded. You truly are the heroic Avenger I hoped you were. With that fog crawler gone, we can send some folks up there to get the place ready for you. That's right. The farm is yours. Your own little piece of the island. It'll take work to get it up and running again, but you'll have help. And here's another 200 caps in gratitude for your service to the great Dalton lineage.
Who else needs to be avenged?
I was just about to explain. Now, I don't have to tell you that the bonds of blood and family are strong as any a person can know. But if you ask me, the strongest among them is the bond that exists between two married people. That's why the last part of this tale is the hardest one for me to tell.
Believe me, I know exactly how you feel.
If that's true, then I'm sorry to hear it. Perhaps we'll confront our pain together. My late husband, Daniel, was the best fisherman this island ever saw. He and his crew had a favorite fishing spot out by Brooks Head Lighthouse. One day, a day I'll never forget, I see Danny's boat pulling up with his crewmen all shouting and carrying on. Turns out some trappers moved into the lighthouse. No doubt because the island told them to. They're all crazier than a bag of mole rats. Their leader was having a little target practice. Shot Danny right between the eyes. Killed him, just like that. You go and get that son of a bitch. You make him pay for doing the island's bidding.
How do I get to the Brooks Head Lighthouse?
It's southwest of town, not far from the quarry.
Wait, did you just call someone else crazy? That is priceless.
What? I don't get your meaning. Ugh, never mind that. Remember, trappers may be half crazy from the fog, but they still know how to use a gun.
You look like you need an ice cold vim.
No thanks.
Pity. I, for one, won't go down unless I'm roaring drunk.
Erna says the island's alive.
Talk with Alan. I don't have time for you.
You need some firepower?
Sandra.
Mainlanders are the source of all our problems. Every single one of them. The children of Adam are trying to kill us all. Drive us into the ocean.
Those tools you found are a joy to work with.
Guns, guns, and more guns.
Mariner says the fog's alive. I can hear you. So mind what you say.
Food. Stim packs. Fully stocked.
You another vulture circling over Andre's body? He ain't dead. Wait. No. It's a mainlander. Well, welcome to my little clinic. If you need doctoring, speak up. I wish I had time for some proper conversation, but my work's never done.
Who's Andre?
Poor Andre is my patient over there. He spent too long a spell in the fog. You may think you know your mainland radiation poisoning, but we got our own special brand here.
I know a few things about medicine. Can I try to help him?
You say, what? You? Help? Well, poor Andre's got it bad. Good as dead. Well, I suppose there's no harm letting you have a poke, but I'll be watching you.
Let's take a look.
I think you may have done it. I'll keep looking after Andre. But I think thanks to you, he's got a fighting chance.
Andre.
Everywhere. It's coming. Oh.
Protect your loved ones with my fine hand cannons.
The bait shop's got everything you need. You know, when I'm feeling down, a little commerce always cheers me up.
Need to drown your troubles? Talk to Mitch at the last blank.
What the hell's bowling? Beaver Creek's got some alley or something.
guess we got no choice.
Looks like Howard didn't make it. I'll have to repair the fog condensers myself.
I hope Howard's okay.
Those fog condensers are back online.
Good. Our water supply was starting to get low. Wasn't sure how much longer we could hold out. Did you find Howard?
Is there a next of kin? If so, you should notify them.
I should never have let him go out there alone. Well, I said it was paying work. 200 caps should be enough.
Is there anything else I can do to help?
Don't know if you've chatted up the Mariner, but she's always looking for help. I know Cassie Dalton was asking around, but... well, judge for yourself there.
Thanks. Glad I can help you out.
That makes two of us. Now, here's your pay. I've got to start making arrangements for Howard. So I'll say goodbye.
Ordinance like that. No wonder you wiped out those crabs.
You are a curious specimen. Despite our friendly town doing its best to chase you out, you keep helping us ingrates all the same. I got to ask, why do you keep at it?
You're good people in some dire straits. Figured you could use a hand.
Huh? You running for office? Well, if that's the truth, we don't deserve
you. Just mind you don't let them take advantage of you.
Most folk here are set in their ways, yes? It makes no difference how hard you try to get in good with them. Heck, it took my family 3 generations before the Daltons would sell us a heel of bread. But there's a way. A downright insane way, mind you. That you can turn even the most stubborn fool around.
Why are some harbormen so hostile to outsiders?
Most of the folk on this rock believe they've been given the God-given right to walk here. Way I figure it, if you got the moxie to survive, you earned your place.
I'd love to change their opinion of me.
Do it right, and all mainlanders might get treated better. In olden times, leaders were chosen by something called the Captain's Dance. Legends say the toughest, meanest, and outright craziest hopefuls would chum the waters and lure out the worst the island could throw at them. Once the would-be captain killed the Mirelur Queen, or Fog Crawler, or what have you, they'd invite the whole island to feast off the bounty. You do this? Well, you won't be made captain, but you'll earn respect. Everyone's respect.
So, if we throw this dance, it'll really change their minds?
The dance hasn't been done in living memory. Some people think the tradition is dead, but its history is soaked deep in this island. You do it, and it'll turn heads for certain.
I'm ready to become a legend, then.
You what? You crack me up. There's an old Mirelur feasting grounds by Emmett's Causeway, a treacherous stretch along the coast. Go there and throw any kind of meat you got into the water. All that blood and viscera will be sure to attract attention. And then wait. I'll make sure there's a witness or two. Prove to the rest of these clods you belong.
Captain Avery's all right, I guess.
Don't let the island's
got enough backbone to stand up to the children.
Bait Shop's got everything you need.
Psst. Looking for a bargain?
I'll take a pass.
Another time.
Your patient, Andre. He's walking around. If I'm not too careful, there's gonna be 2 doctors in the harbor.
How's it going?
People around here have had a hard go of it. And manners on this island are a bit sparse in the best of times. Mainlanders tend to be a bit friendlier, all told. So I always enjoy the extra company.
No problems here.
Fuck you.
The doctor has said in time, I will fully recover. He says this is your doing, but I do not know you.
I was just doing my civic duty.
You are obviously not from here. Gratitude. It's a hard thing out here. So, yeah, this island. It has taken my husband. It has taken everything. This island is a sickness. Don't you see? It's evil. As soon as I am well, I am going to grab as many guns as I can carry, and I will slaughter everything in my path until the island is clean, or I am no more.
Really? That's your plan?
The island wants all of us dead. If it wants me, it can try to take me.
You're in pain. Yeah, I've been there. but your plan is unreasonable. Find a purpose, some constructive purpose, to keep you going.
You wouldn't know. Once, Far Harbor was, well, not thriving, but alive. I'll think on what you said.
Stranger, you need odds, ends, junk, or knickknacks, you've come to the right place.